Testing 1, 2, 3. In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad, the 1400 years ago, is the last messenger and servant and prophet to the worlds. As I greet you in the greeting words of peace, we say it in the Arabic language. The universal greetings of As-Salaam Alaikum, and we add Rahmatullah wa Barakatuhu, which means in English, may the peace and mercy and blessings of Allah be upon you. My short lecture, as we say in Arabic, Kutba, is called The Origin and Original Practice of Halloween in America. And most of our people never give thought as to what they are really celebrating. You go along in life and follow along with established things and ideas of this country, but never really give any real in-depth thought and contemplate and study the origin of the holidays and all celebrations in America that you engage yourself, your family, and your children in. You are a go-along with the crowd people, a go-along to get along people. And as a result, this is destroying our people, destroying the children, destroying our communities. If you know something is evil against you and your people, you should never go along to get along. You should fight against those practices, ideas, philosophies that are aimed at your destruction as a nation of black people. Have you ever given the thought about this Halloween? Or have you just went along with things because everyone else is doing it? Because America has made it a celebration. Most likely you have done the latter, like I used to be as a child. It's a celebration in America. It's nationally recognized as a celebration. It runs through the family as a tradition. So you think it's okay to celebrate it. But let's look at this celebration. The background of the celebration, Halloween, originated as a pagan festival in parts of Northern Europe. It has nothing to do with coming out of Africa, particularly around what is now the United Kingdom. Many European cultural traditions hold that Halloween is a time when magic is most potent and spirits can make contact with the physical world. In Christian times, it became a celebration of the evening before All Saints' Day. Immigrants from Scotland and Ireland brought the holiday to the United States. The commercialization of Halloween started in the 1900s when postcards and die-cut paper decorations were produced. Halloween costumes started to appear in stores in the 1930s, and the custom of trick-or-treat appeared in the 1950s. The types of products available in Halloween style increased with time. Now, Halloween is a very profitable holiday for the manufacturers of costumes, yard decorations, and candy. Some of the symbols of Halloween which varies. These include spooks, ghosts, and walking skeletons, goblins, and that represent the contact between the spiritual and physical world and between the living and the dead. Human figures that are often represented on Halloween are witches and wizards who are seen to have the power to contact the spirit world. Bats, black cats, and spiders are often connected with this holiday. These animals are associated with the night and darkness and often accompany witches and wizards. There are also a range of objects associated with Halloween. These include blood, fire, gravestones, pumpkins, bones, and skulls. They all have connections with death. The spirit world are protecting property from evil spirits. Many of these objects are now available in stores of decorations for the Halloween season. And we are in that season that America and the European nations have ordained that Halloween should be. But this celebration is a celebration against God Himself. You follow along with the devil. You become the devil. And will have to be punished by God for it. You follow the devil. You become an enemy to God Himself. And those that are truly serving Him. America has taken the way of other than Allah, God's way. Or whatever name you call him. He has 99 attributes to his main name, which is Allah. This is why the black communities are in shambles because of following the ways of the heathen from Europe. Let's look at this symbolism here in America. Halloween is basically the worship of the dead, a pagan holiday. Death and murder was the order of the day in the days of slavery. And when the Caucasian nations went to steal our fathers and mothers' lands, death and murder was the only thing on the minds of these devil Caucasians from Europe, with the theme of no mercy. One thing you cannot deny is that these people were and are the real devil on earth. History tells the story of the brutal, hate-filled Caucasian people killing and murdering for the fun of it. This whole idea, steal the black man's lands, put him in fear of pale white power. This is the theme of Halloween. Be afraid. In America, the original practice, the original mask of Halloween was the Ku Klux Klan mask. When the black man and woman seen that mask, that sheet of the Klan, they knew what it meant for them. Our fathers and mothers, lynching and death. Fear is the theme of Halloween. Nigga, be afraid. If we look at the word haunt, haunt means to visit often. Study your dictionary. And as we look back at our history, who would visit us in the nights to make us afraid? A band of pale-faced devils, the Ku Klux Klan, or some hateful pale-faced devils in the back of a pickup truck, or the police trying to lynch us? Our fathers and mothers were visited all day, every single day, with injustice, hatred, segregation, lynching, slave labor, raping, killing, and murder. Just plain extreme hell on earth. We have been living in a haunted house of America for hundreds and hundreds of years. Caucasians today are trying to make you forget this, while at the same time repeating it. What does this pumpkin on Halloween represent? Do you know the real hatred of this celebration and the root meaning in America and all around the world of these symbols? It represents the black man and woman's head being lynched with a rope around the bottom of the head, or head strung up by a rope. It represents the devil, Caucasian, cutting the black man and woman's head off and posting it on post to let the other black people see it, to give them a message, to make sure you be a slave to pale white power. Black woman, you were lynched too. You were beat too. But you also were sexually exploited and raped beyond imagination by this devil, pale Caucasian. This celebration of Halloween is a satanic, savage, bloody, barbarous, and devilish celebration, disgracing black life and despised and condemned by God Himself. Stop this foolishness. Stop celebrating this hateful holiday. Have you ever wondered about the words trick or treat? In Europe, they were into molesting little boys. It was a thing to do, just as the Catholic priests have been doing to little boys. A trick, in street terms, is a person that spends money for sex. In regular terms, you give to a child or a dog as a reward or for a lure. The Catholic Church has always been giving treats to the children. Santa Claus putting your child on a fat, pale white man's lap while giving your child a treat, a piece of candy. Integrating yourself into this world of the Caucasian is causing you to disgrace yourself and your family. We are a royal people from the shores of Africa that have traveled every seas and ocean and inhabited every piece of land and scanned every piece of sky before this Caucasian even came out of the Caucasus mountains. Now you follow along with these celebrations that are so hateful and against God himself that it is doing nothing but making you a slave and causing you to gain the wrath of Almighty God Allah. And after listening to this speech, and you still celebrate this Halloween hatred, then you are a slave and an enemy of God himself. As I greet you in the greeting words of peace, we say it in the Arabic language of Assalamu Alaikum. And we add Rahman to Allah wa Barakatuh, which means in English, may the peace and mercy and blessings of Allah be upon you. I am Montreal Muhammad.